Hello guys, my name is Anna and I vlog daily from Ukraine since the start of brutal Russian invasion. If you support Ukraine, please subscribe and share the videos that you consider interesting or important. And today I want to speak a little bit more about cluster munition that Ukraine is supposed to receive because of the decision of the United States. I've got lots of questions in comments, in Twitter and on Instagram and in threads. Do subscribe to me on these platforms and the links are below the video. So I've received lots of questions and comments concerning this decision and I feel like I need to translate some things back to you. So first of all, before the start of this war, I was a person who hated any military topics, any military clothes even. I was never into war, history of war, I don't know, war films, I don't know. But today I realized that to win this war and to survive, we have to fight. We cannot give up, we cannot negotiate, we cannot stop and observe. And to win this war, we do need weapons. Once again, in this ideal world, of course, I would like no weapons to exist at all. No guns, no tanks, no missiles. But after brutal Russian invasion of my free and independent country with thousands of missiles destroying Ukrainian lives, I realize we have to fight back and to protect ourselves. So we do need all possible types of ammunition and weapons to use them to protect our territory and our people. I realize that cluster munition is not something simple. It is an advanced type of weapons that can be dangerous for civilian people too. But once again, when you think about this ideal world and normal environment, of course, cluster bombs are bad. But when you think about full-scale war and hundreds of kilometers of already mined soils, Ukrainian soils by Russian orcs, you have to understand that we speak and we treat this event from a totally different perspective. And let me clarify why. First of all, the territories where cluster munitions will be used are mined already. So they are dangerous and not suitable for civilians. And it will take us decades after our victory to make these territories available for life. Why are they mined? Because Russian orcs tried to back up their positions. They were building defense lines. They have three lines of defense, actually. And that's why for Ukrainian counteroffensive, it is so difficult to move forward. But we've managed already to break the first line. Ukrainians started this counteroffensive being in a weaker position to a great extent, because despite being very brave and really strong and well-trained and super motivated, we do not have that many people as Russia does. Remember, 140 million population. And we don't have that many weapons because first they were preparing to any kind of war for decades, starting from the Cold War period. And they invested lots of money in that. Well, like, this is the largest country in the world and it was getting ready for this war. So they outstand us in people and in weapons. And we managed to start our counteroffensive and to conduct it successfully from a weaker position. Why? Once again, because we are stronger, we are more motivated, we are on our land, and we have support of the best allies and modern weapons. But to conduct counteroffensive without the support from the air is impossible. And most of cluster munitions will be used to break the lines of Russian infantry and once again on the territories that are already mined. Another very important aspect that people forget about is that Russians use cluster munitions on Ukrainian troops and Ukrainian civilians since the beginning of this war. So it is not that we bring something new to Ukrainian territories, something that can cause new destructions and something that we did not experience previously. Unfortunately, since the beginning of this war, Russian orcs are using every kind of weapon they can. They train, they destroy, they kill, they terrorize. I think they were even using chemical weapons, though it is not like proved, but lots of Ukrainian soldiers have already received specific protection against chemical weapons, and I think it must be for a specific reason. This cassette, I'm sorry, it's in Ukrainian with the word cassette, but perhaps in the English, the correct version is a cluster munition. In Ukrainian, this will be not cluster bomb, but kasetna bomba. So that is why I made a mistake. So anyway, the South is mined. The South is a hot zone where Russian orcs use cluster munition. And what this supply gives us is just the opportunity to use them back against Russian infantry, against their defense line, and to be able to use in aviation. And to sum it all up, of course, in the normal world, and I hope that one day we will create a new normal world, because we cannot return back to this classical normal world because of Russia. But when we will create a new normal world and people will live safely and respect each other's histories, languages and boundaries, most importantly, we will be able to speak that all weapons are bad, because they are bad, because they cause death. But when the largest country in the world and the nuclear country attacks you and wants to erase your nation, you have to protect yourself by all means available. That's why Ukraine is constantly asking for everything, for every kind of supply that can help us. Moreover, we've committed a couple of mistakes in our past, like we gave up our nuclear weapons. Once again, I would like to live in an ideal world where you don't need nuclear weapons and you can give them up, and people will say, oh, you are so sustainable, you're environmentally friendly, you are the best country in the world. But it turned out that we are the silliest country in the world, and we have to play according to these rules and to ask for more weapons to protect our territories, to take all Russian soldiers out of Ukraine and to start rebuilding. That's the only thing we want. But unfortunately, on the way to this victory, we do need to fight. We need to lose our people, and this is happening. The territories are already mined. Cluster munitions are already used in Ukraine, together with all other weapons available to Russian orcs. Please don't forget about that. Yesterday, I have watched a very beautiful video of Vlad Wexler about the ethics of cluster munition, and I will link I will link the link to this video in my vlog. So if you have some doubts and you need some thoughts, please go and check this video. And also, I'm happy to announce that we have our 500th customer, if it's possible to say so, in our shop. And that is Neil Cook from the United Kingdom. And we will contact Neil and discuss the most comfortable way of the delivery of this book by Alexander Paly, A History of Ukraine. Also, we love this initiative so much with your comments and your purchases that we have decided we will give similar presents to every 100th customer. So introduce yourself to our beautiful merch and I will update you who will be the 600th. Thank you so much for your support. Thank you for buying me coffees, becoming my patrons. Thank you for your kind comments and thank you for your good wishes. We all wait for NATO summit in Vilnius. What will it mean? Please let me know in comments, what do you think about Vilnius NATO meeting, and can we expect something good for Ukraine? And also, I would like to know your attitude to the supply of cluster munition to Ukraine. I always carefully read the comments. Once again, thank you so much for being with me. Subscribe to me on different platforms. The links are in the description of this video. Slava Ukraini!